Hello, you beautiful 99ers. I am Sway to the 99, and I'm super excited because I am finally back with my cooking videos. I know many of you have been wondering where I've been, what's going on with my cooking videos, and I decided to take a little bit of a break. Just a lot going on here at home, so I just needed a little bit of a break, but I am finally back, and I'm super excited because today's is not actually a cooking video per se. It is more of a cocktail. And I think this is still a really fun idea since summer, we're still technically in summertime, despite the little fall decor right there. and I'm actually gonna do a more decor right there. I'm actually gonna be doing a separate video on my home decor using all items that I found at Target, Dollar Tree, the 99. So you guys get to see a little glimpse of my updated home decor, but that's for a later video. But today's video is actually a family-friendly mocktail. So basically cocktails without the alcohol so that kids can enjoy these as well. So I'm gonna show you two of my favorite. The first is gonna be a delicious mojito, which I actually showed you guys how to make on the 99's Instagram. I took over their Instagram page a few weeks ago and I showed you guys how to make that. So I'm gonna replicate that today to show you guys if you missed that one. And I'm also gonna make a very delicious pina colada. If you guys have watched me for a while, you guys know that I love pineapple. So I thought this would be a great idea to incorporate. So I will be back officially now with my cooking videos and I'll be posting those every Friday. So make sure you are make sure you are tuned and subscribe. I'm so excited, I can't even speak. All right, so with that, let's jump right in and get these refreshing drinks started. Oh, and look, I'm wearing my pineapple apron, Sway to the 99. Shout out to RJ Olives. All right, so let's start off with the mojito, which is really simple. And don't worry, guys, I will be listing all of the ingredients and measurements down below. So the first thing you do want to do is cut up your lemons, or limes, lemons, limes. I always get them confused. But anyway, you basically just want to cut them up in fours, as you guys see right there. And yes, I am using my Martha Stewart utensils that I did grab at the 99. And I actually love this knife. It works really well. So for this, you want to use about two whole lemons into your, or limes, into your drink. And then we're going to actually juice half of one. So you're going to basically end up using two and a half. There we go. Perfect. So we have that ready. And next you want to grab about seven leaves, throw it into your cups to two, three, just, you know, grab a handful, four. You guys get the idea. and you obviously just be as generous as you'd like. If you like mint, throw in a little more. Sorry about that, I'm blocking the way. So yeah, if you guys like mint, you can definitely throw in a little more. I definitely like mint, so here we go. Throw that in there. Basically just throw in all of your lemon. There we go. And now we're going to begin muddling. This is where basically you juice your lemons or your limes. Okay, I really need to get that figured out. But anyway, just basically you just smash them down like that until they're nice and pretty much pretty beat up. And then you're gonna throw in your sugar. There we go. And then just continue doing a little bit more so that way all of the ingredients start to get all blended in together, including the sugar. And that's gonna give you that nice sweet and sour taste. You can see right there. There we go. And this is super easy, you guys. This is almost like pretty much the entire cocktail right here. All right, so I think that is good. We're gonna put that aside. Next, we're gonna cut up our third lime, or lemon, and we're just gonna juice it. Go right there. You guys can see. All right, perfect. So we're just gonna put this to the side for right now. Next, we are actually going to grab our ice. Let me get that, and then I'll pour this in, so be right back. Okay, so now we're gonna throw in some of our ice. And I did try to get fancy with it, so I did blend up or crush up some of the ice so it's not complete ice cubes. There we go. I'm just gonna throw in a little more. And don't worry if things are obviously at the bottom of the glass, because we are going to mix this up. All right, so next you're going to want to pour in your half squeeze. There we go. Woo. It's like a skating rink up in here. All right, next we're going to throw in some of our sparkling mineral water. You can use either flavor. I picked up the lemon flavor here at the 99. Pour some of that in. There we go. I think it's almost ready. Add it in our straw. Then we can just kind of mix it in with our straw just to make sure that some of the limes and mint from the bottom kind of make their way up to the top. So that way you get that nice full mojito look that you're used to. There we go. Just gonna mix it up a little bit more. And then we're just gonna top it off with a little bit of mint just to give it that nice look for the Instagram. There we go. Perfect. There we have our mojito. So I'm gonna give it a quick taste test and let you guys know what I think. All right, so time for the taste test and see what I think. Oh, it's so good. So if you guys wanna make this into a adult beverage, all you simply gotta do is pour in your favorite rum. But this, as is, it's perfect, so the kids can definitely enjoy a nice little mojito without the alcohol. And the best part is you can find all these ingredients at the 99 cent only store. I mean, if you don't have a 99 cent only store, these are very affordable items you can pick up at any local grocery store. So cheers. All right, so now let's jump into how to make a pina colada. Ooh, I'm excited. All right, let's jump right into that one. All right, so this one is actually really simple as well. This one's actually even easier. You literally just throw in your ingredients into the blender and mix everything in. So what we are gonna do first is we're gonna blend in our coconut milk with our crushed, freshly cut pineapple. And I actually did purchase the pineapple the day before, yesterday, at the 99, and I cut it up in our cream. And again, I'm gonna be including our measurements at the end in the video description so you guys can follow along. So what I did do, I cut up my fresh pineapple. I froze it overnight so it's nice and fresh. You really get that, really good consistency. You know what, I'm gonna add a little bit more milk. Okay, so first we are gonna blend these ingredients and then we're gonna add in the ice. So you don't wanna put the ice in together. You wanna blend this first. You wanna make sure that these ingredients combine together, and then you want to top it off with your ice. So close your ears. Okay, so now that you have everything blended, you want to pour in all right, so now that we have our content pretty much blended in, you want to throw in some ice and blend it in as well. So you want to make sure it all gets nice and mixed in together. Let's see. There we go. Close your ears. And with this, you don't want it necessarily completely blended out. You want to have a little bit of chunks so it's still a little bit hearty. You guys can still hear the chunks in there. So I think that is... Yeah, I think this is ready. Ooh, it smells good. All right, so I'm gonna pour it into our cup. There we go. Perfect. You wanna have that nice, kind of a thicker consistency. There we go. Ooh, making a mess. Okay, and here is our drink. I'm gonna give it a quick taste and let you guys know what I think. All right, so for the moment of truth, how does it taste? Let me see, let you guys know what I think. Oh my God, this is perfect. And as I mentioned, if you wanna make it an alcohol-friendly cocktail, you simply need to add your favorite rum. So good. The only thing I did forget to grab are some cherry stuff to top it off, but you can always just add a little garnish, add a little piece of pineapple or just cherries, whatever you prefer. But honestly, it's good the way it is. Oh my God, this is so good. I hope you guys try these with the kiddos at home. Again, these are family friendly because they do not contain alcohol, but it gives you the nice summer vibe. So if you're having a barbecue outside or you're gonna be celebrating Memorial Day, perfect time to make a nice little cocktail. And they are putting the summer stuff on clearance at the 99 cent only store. So perfect time to check them out. Or you could also even check out the Dollar Tree for some of the ingredients. Like, I think they have pineapple, frozen pineapple. So you guys can easily make most of the cocktails using items that I found at the 99 cent only store or the Dollar Tree. So thank you so much for watching. As a quick reminder, I do have a giveaway going on right now in my Thanksgiving store walkthrough / haul. So I will link that video down below. So if you're watching this before Sunday the 9th, there is still time to enter for the giveaway. So yeah, I will be back later this week for my 99 cent only store walkthrough. So thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And as always, don't forget to do the 99.